Today, we're going to talk about how to connect your audio interface to Pro Tools. And I'm also going to throw in a little bonus tip to make sure you can actually record once you've done that. Hello and welcome. My name is Malcolm Owen-Flood. Today, we are going to be talking about how to connect your audio interface into Pro Tools, as I mentioned. And this is really a very, very beginner-friendly episode. This is for people that don't know how to connect their audio interface, which is kind of like the first necessary step. So we're trying to help beginners here. And this channel has a lot of stuff like that for people that are trying to learn how to use Pro Tools or get started in recording in general. So if that sounds like you, please do subscribe and we'll get you recording in no time. And first off, I think we should talk about what is an audio interface. This is an audio interface. This is just one. If you have a different one, comment down below. Let me know what you're using and I'd be happy to help you figure out that interface as well. But this video is going to help you regardless. You don't need to have this interface to learn from this at all. It's just, what is one? And this is essentially a way of getting audio from the outside world and into your computer, which is converting it from analog to digital, but also the other way around, getting sounds from inside of your computer and playing them out through speakers, which is digital to analog conversion. So we've got analog to digital and digital to analog. There's of course preamps built in to help amplify our audio signal on the way in. We've got a monitor controller. You probably have a headphone out. There's all sorts of things, but at its core, it is a way of getting sound in and out of your computer. And that is why you need one if you want to be recording. Now that we know what an audio interface actually is, let's talk about our required equipment to get through this video. Of course, we are going to need an audio interface, and it could be any interface as long as it is capable of connecting and working with your computer. So just make sure it's compatible. That is kind of the only requirement you're going to need. In addition to that, you're probably going to need some kind of cabling to actually connect it to your computer. For me, this is worth mentioning, I think, actually. This interface is an old Thunderbolt 2 connector, I think, and I've got USB-C on my computer. So I have an adapter, and this adapter lets me plug it into my computer. Totally necessary to have the right cables to connect from your interface to your computer, and worth looking at what those connections are before you buy your interface as well, if you are still waiting to buy one. And once you've got your interface and your necessary cables, we can just plug them in and move on to the next step of our setup, which is going to be the software setup and configuration. Before we actually even worry about Pro Tools, I want to make sure that you can get your interface working with your computer, period. That is a very good first step. So we're going to do that by just making sure that the computer sees our interface and then can receive sound from it. So what I want you to do is go to your applications folder or whatever you have if you're on a Windows, and then go to your audio MIDI setup. And that'll have its own name inside of a Windows computer, I'm sure. But for us Mac users, that is what it's called. And then from this, you're gonna see a whole list of different IO kind of audio devices. And in my case, I wanna use the interface that I've got connected for this video, which is just over here. And that is my little mix pre. It's not actually this one because I use a different one for my videos. Select the interface that you're using and have plugged into your computer. So I'm gonna right click on that and I'm gonna use this device for my sound output. And we could also use it for our sound input if we wanted as well, but I'm not gonna mess with that because of my video. But for you, you're gonna wanna set it as both. So what that means is that our computer is gonna now use the audio device we just selected to play back anything we play on our computer. So instead of using the speakers on my laptop, it is now gonna use the audio interface that I selected. And we can just test that by going and playing anything that we want. So I've got a song sitting right here by a band named Cold Fame that I mastered this song. I click play and we hear the audio and we can see it coming in here. Actually, is a really important thing too. We should be able to see the audio hitting the interface, and almost every interface has audio metering. So that'll come up again, but just know that if you see it, that's a good sign. Now, if you don't see your audio interface on this audio MIDI setup page and you're wondering, well, I can't select it, it's not there. Don't worry, we're gonna cover that a little later in the video. But now it is time to actually move this into Pro Tools and connect it to Pro Tools. We wanna connect your audio interface to Pro Tools. That is the whole point of this video, and we need you to be able to record as a result. Pro Tools is open, but you don't see anything. What you might see if you have this selected, show and startup, is this page. But you actually want to close that. Just click cancel. And Pro Tools is still launched because you can see that. And you want to go to setup, playback engine. And the reason I wanted you to close that is because for some reason, if you're on this page, you can't open playback engine. It's grayed out, but it's absolutely necessary to be able to open that. So we cancel that. We go to setup, playback engine, and right here, the very first thing is our device playback engine. And you have to make sure that your interface is selected there. And it might not be. It doesn't always just know to do that. It probably will just be on whatever made sense the last time you used it. So if you opened Pro Tools and didn't have your interface connected to your computer, it might be defaulted to your MacBook Pro speakers, for example. And if you had a different interface connected before the one that you're trying to get working right now, it might have that one selected. So in this case, I have my MixPre 6 as my audio interface, and that's what we're looking at right over here. You can see my voice is moving the audio meters on it, and I've selected that. Once you've selected that, you're going to click OK. Don't worry about everything else on this page just yet. We're going to circle back to talk about this, especially this little hardware buffer size, because that is important. But first things first, just select the interface that you are trying to work with today. We click OK, and it will now use that interface. There might be a loading that goes on if it has to change some stuff, but don't worry about that. It'll work just fine. Now I'm going to go to File and open an example session I made for this. And this is essentially what a blank session looks like in Pro Tools, right? We've got our click track here, and if I click play, we now see the click. You can hear it, and you can actually see it recording into my interface. So we're seeing the audio come in. That's the most important part, and we should be able to hear it. If you see audio on your interface through the meters that are displayed on your physical interface, that means that you should be able to hear it. And if you're not hearing it, that means one of maybe three things. It probably means that you have not turned up the volume control on your interface. So there's a physical volume control on this one. It is this big knob. Start turning it up, see if that helps. If it doesn't, maybe turn it back down, because if you click a button that unmutes it and it's cranked, you might regret that. But that brings me to the next option. It might be a mute button. This has a mute button. If that is selected, it mutes the signal. That's an intentional thing. And if you have that accidentally selected, you're not going to hear anything, of course. And then there's probably actually one third option, and that would be software. You might actually need some software that is tied to your interface. A lot of interfaces these days actually come with software. For Universal Audio and the Apollo, this one here, it comes with this console software, Universal Audio Console. And this is just a way of controlling this using my computer, but it also allows me to go deeper than I can with just the buttons on this thing. So you may have to mess around there. You're gonna have to look at the user manual of whatever you've got. I really recommend reading it for your own good. But for example, if I clicked mute here, my speakers would be muted. I wouldn't hear anything. I wouldn't know unless I came and actually looked at the software. While we have seen that audio is coming out of Pro Tools into my interface by me using this click track as an example, there it goes. We also need to make sure audio is getting into Pro Tools, because it's a two-way street. We need to get sound out of our computer to our interface, that is the digital to analog, but we also need to go analog to digital. So for example, getting my voice into the session here. So I've set up a little test audio track here, and I've got the interface selected to input one, which I have plugged into input one with this microphone that is recording my voice right now. And if I turn that on, record enable it, it looks like it's working. Click record. This is a test. This is me recording audio inside of Pro Tools. You should see that you can see my audio coming into my interface over on this display here, and you should see it recording into Pro Tools on the screen here. Okay, zoom out. It looks good. I see it there, and let's play it back. This is a test. This is me recording audio inside of Pro Tools. We could see it on the interface. We could see it in Pro Tools. We could hear it. It's all happening. It's what we want. Now, one important detail that we're not going to go super deep on this video is the idea and topic of I/O, which is inputs and outputs. And you can actually look at your interfaces and Pro Tools routed inputs and outputs by going to Setup I/O. Click that, and we've got our inputs panel here, another tab for outputs and buses and so forth. Inputs and outputs are the really important ones because they should map directly to your interface. And Pro Tools does a really good job at doing this automatically, but it can be wrong, and you can actually mess it up yourself if you're not careful. Hopefully, you don't need to do anything here. On the left here is Pro Tools. On the right here is my interface. You can see MixPre here, and I've got actual 8 channels on this interface, and channels 1 and 2 map to 1 and 2 inside of Pro Tools. And it's very logical that way. That means that when I'm selecting what input I want my mic to record through, I can just select 1 because I plugged into input 1 on my interface. It's very logical, but you can change that if for some reason you wanted it to be different. You can do whatever you want. The I/O matrix inside of Pro Tools is actually super powerful, really great. You can do whatever you want. I love that about it, but it's also more advanced than you need to know about right now. Should be plug and play, but just be aware that exists, and just be careful when you're poking around in it as well. Earlier in the video, I mentioned that that I would cover what to do if you don't see your interface on any of these pages. And by that, I mean if you go to your audio MIDI setup and your interface doesn't show up as an option here, or if you go to Pro Tools and your playback engine does not have the option of the interface you are trying to connect, what should you do? And that really boils down to software, most likely. It means that you need to just download the software that is meant to be paired with your interface. So be sure to look for any, you know, cardboard cards inside of your interface's box if you bought it new, or just Google it online. You'll probably have to make an account and they'll give you some firmware. You can download that. As I mentioned, for me, that is console with this universal audio interface that I'm primarily using. And I cannot run this interface without this software being installed on my system. It is 100% necessary. Won't work if I don't do that. So just be aware that if you haven't installed the necessary software and drivers, your interface just won't communicate with your computer at all. You won't see it. It won't work. Totally necessary. And beyond that, it's also worth the note that when you do install that, you might need to reboot your system and power cycle the interface to get that connection to work. It's always good practice. But I've also got a bonus tip for you as promised. And for that, we're going to want to go back to Pro Tools. And this is assuming you've got everything working. You've gone through the steps we followed in this video. Your interface is powered on. You're seeing signal come in and out. You're able to record into Pro Tools and see the audio captured there. You're recording. You've done it. Congratulations. You've earned it. It is super daunting and overwhelming your first time. I remember how scary it was getting this going and feeling like, am I going to have to go through this every time? It gets easier. I promise. Well done. You're over the hurdle. But you might have noticed that actually when I recorded my voice, there was kind of this weird flammy thing going on, depending on how I mix this, if you can hear both the mic and the capture at the same time, because there's a delay. The audio that we're hearing through Pro Tools is a little later than my audio being captured through just this external recorder or me in the real world. And that is called latency, and it is annoying, but a reality of recording. But luckily, we can pretty much eliminate it. So let's cover latency a little bit more thoroughly, just in case, like I said at the beginning of this video, it's for beginners, and that's totally fine. If you are trying to record and you strum your guitar into your mic and then you hear it later in your headphones, that is latency. That's what we're trying to avoid. We want that latency to be as small as possible so that we can't distinguish that there's actually latency at all. And that's really easy to do. I've got it set up right now with this hardware buffer size maxed out to 1024 sample. And that is a larger buffer size. And what that means is that the computer is being allowed to think about what it's going to do for 1024 samples before it actually plays the audio back to me. I've said, hey, you're allowed this much breathing room to do what you need to do behind the hood, do your computer magic stuff, then spit me back the audio 1024 samples later. And that is really good if I'm mixing, but if I'm recording, that is a big delay and it's going to throw me off. It's going to be hard to play with other tracks I've recorded. It's just not going to feel right. It won't feel like I'm playing with musicians in a room. So we need to lower that. And we need to lower that as much as you can, as much as your computer can handle. And that's an important thing to know. How low you can get this is going to be impacted by your computer's ability to process CPU and audio. If you have it really low at 32 samples, it's going to be quick. You won't notice that latency. At least I don't. I can record at 128, no problem. Probably 256 if I really had to. But 32 feels awesome. Feels like real time. 1024, not going to work. Not going to enjoy that process, honestly. And 1024 is actually not that high. With this interface, I can go much higher than that, which is, again, fantastic for mixing and mastering. But for recording, low. So once we're mixing and we're mastering, we're no longer doing like recording in real time. We don't need to worry about latency because I just click play. There's a tiny little delay and then it plays the sound to me. There's nothing to sync to. It all works out. But when I'm recording, I need this to be as low as possible. So when you set up your interface, click the interface and then immediately go down here and set this to as low as you can because you're probably about to start recording. If your computer is struggling with that, bump it up one. If it's struggling with that, bump it up one more. Just start low and then you'll figure out how your computer is able to cope. And as your session progresses and you add more and more instruments and more plugins and more software instruments, you're going to need to slowly creep this up probably. But at a certain point, it'll be too much if you go any further. So That's a whole nother video about committing tracks and freeing up CPU so you can keep this buffer size low. But just know that for now, keep it low, you'll be happy. As far as the rest of this, this isn't really related, but let's cover it. Ignore errors during playback. You can select that so that if your buffer size is causing any errors, which will normally stop it, it'll stop recording or stop playing back. You can just say, no, keep playing and just have pops and just deal with the errors. I'll take them. I never click that because I don't want pops in my recording. I want it to sound like it's meant to sound. So personally, I leave that off. Dynamic plugin processing, I leave on. And that just means that if there's silence in the audio, so if I do this, let's clear out a big chunk here. And I had a plugin sitting here. Let's throw up this Cornif Audio one. Great plugin for guitars, by the way. Great company, love those guys. Now, when this is playing over this green, over the audio clip, this plugin is going to be taking up CPU. It's going to be using the computer's resources. But once it hits here, it's going to pretend that this plugin's turned off. So dynamic plugin processing pretty much means when there's audio on the track, it's turned on. But when there's no audio on the track, it's turned off. So very good thing to have inside of your session. And then optimize performance at low buffer sizes. This can also help you like keep the session moving smooth if you have low buffers. But this brief system hangs. I don't know if that's good or bad. I leave it off and I haven't had any issues. You can experiment with turning that on to see if it improves your situation, but my computer's a powerhouse, haven't needed it. And then limit number of real threads. And this is just going to help prioritize Pro Tools processing essentially. So if you have a bunch of other programs running at the same time, which I don't recommend, maybe consider clicking this on as well. And then playback cache, I leave that at normal at all times. I've never needed to change it, honestly. So the big one though is hardware buffer size. Get that low if you're recording. You'll thank me later. And that about sums it up. Get your interface, get the cable you need, plug it into your computer, power it on, download whatever software you need for your interface, and then select the audio input device on your computer and in Pro Tools. One more note. I told you there wasn't going to be, but there is. What you select here in audio MIDI setup doesn't actually matter with what's happening in Pro Tools. They're separate. So you could leave your built-in MacBook speakers selected in audio MIDI setup, but then in Pro Tools, select your interface. And then if you played something on Spotify, for example, it would come out of your laptop speakers. But if you play something in Pro Tools, it'll come out of your studio speakers or whatever's connected to your audio interface. Good little distinction there, but it is good practice just to set it in both so that you don't have audio coming from all over the place and it's coming from where you expect. And then, yeah, once you've selected your audio interface in audio MIDI setup and in your DAW, you can then test that it's working by playing something from inside of your DAW and seeing if it's coming to your interface, recording something from your interface and seeing that you're getting it in Pro Tools. And assuming you are, you should be off to the races. You should be hearing audio and you should be ready to start recording. Congratulations, you've earned it. And if you enjoyed this video, please do consider subscribing. If you have any specific questions for me, please comment them down below. I'm happy to try and help just by commenting back or potentially even making another video. But for now, I've got a whole nother bunch of videos coming up for you right here and here, and I will see you in the next one. Adios.